Hello all, this is Dr. Alsip, and I am super excited to talk about the muscles in the anterior next session. We have quite a bit to go through, but I think you will find many are very aptly named, so we better get started. We will start with the most superficial muscle of the anterior neck, and this is the platysma, which you can see here that I am outlining. You can see that it's a rather expansive muscle, but it is a very, very thin muscle. This muscle is literally located within the subcutaneous tissue, like most other muscles of facial expression, but this particular muscle of facial expression is specifically located in the anterior lateral neck. So we have platysma on either side here. Specifically, this muscle typically spans the space between the superior margins of the pectoralis major and the deltoid muscle over here in terms of its inferior margin, and it will extend superiorly to about the inferior margins of the rest of the muscles of facial expression, so right around the inferior margins of the mandible. So if we were to remove the skin up here, you may see some extension into this region. If you can see the platysma muscle in the anterior neck, you are not seeing many other structures of the neck because it would be superficial to most other structures. So if you're not seeing the carotid sheath, if you're not seeing the thyroid gland or the infrahyoid muscles, you're likely looking at the platysma muscle. It's a fairly distinct looking muscle. Next, let's figure out how we are going to identify the sternocleidomastoid muscle. The sternocleidomastoid muscle is often abbreviated SCM, so you will often hear us refer to it as that in subsequent portions of the course. The name of the sternocleidomastoid muscle tells you a lot about the attachments of this muscle. The sterno, so the sterno portion, means its attachment to the sternum, specifically the manubrium, so you can see that right about here-ish. It's going to be down in this region. Cleido means clavicle, meaning its attachment to the medial third of the clavicle. Mastoid indicates the superior attachment of the muscle to the mastoid process, so heading up into this region here. So the mastoid process is of the temporal bone, which is that bump that you can feel right under your ear. The superior attachment will wrap around to the superior nuchaline as well. So this large rope-like muscle is going to be the sternocleidomastoid. And you can see both on this particular image. You can also see in these images the external jugular vein, which will run superficial to the muscle as well. So that's another important anatomical relationship. This muscle is an important component in the anterior neck and serves as a major player in the division of the cervical triangles. So we'll come back to this one over and over again. Moving into the infrahyoid or strap muscles, these muscles largely occupy the area inferior to the hyoid. So here's your hyoid here. So these strap muscles will be inferior to the hyoid, but superior to the sternum. Your sternum's going to be here. These are your clavicles here. And they will also be medial to the carotid sheath. So you can see carotid sheath components here. So this is true for all infrahyoid muscles, excepting the inferior belly of omohyoid. There are two groups of infrahyoid muscles, the superficial and deep, and we are looking at a dissection of the superficial infrahyoid muscles. The most medial is going to be the sternohyoid, which I am tracing here and over here. The sternohyoid is going to be longer than the two deeper infrahyoid muscles as it extends between the sternum up all the way to the hyoid bone. So you would have to reflect or move this muscle in order to see those deeper infrahyoid muscles. The omohyoid is pretty distinct looking. It is going to be lateral to the sternohyoid, but it consists of two bellies that are connected by an intermediate tendon. And you can see that intermediate tendon here. The superior belly, which I am labeling right here, the superior belly is going to connect the body of the hyoid to that intermediate tendon. The inferior belly, which which I'm labeling I, that inferior belly is going to connect the intermediate tendon all the way to the upper border of the scapula. So that's the scapula of the shoulder. That's where the OMO comes from in its name. This intermediate tendon is going to be anchored to the clavicle via what we like to call a fascial sling. And you can see that is a fairly pronounced one on this particular donor, the fascial sling. Now moving to a deeper dissection, you know this is a deeper dissection because you do not have that long sternohyoid that extends from the sternum all the way to the hyoid. Instead, you have two muscles that are going to span that space, so you know you're looking at a deeper dissection. The sternothyroid, which I am labeling here for outlining, so the sternothyroid connects the manubrium of the sternum to the oblique line of the thyroid cartilage, and that's a little hard to see here. You can see kind of right around this region of the prominence of the thyroid, and that oblique line is going to be located right about here. So that's going to be the sternothyroid. The thyrohyoid, the thyrohyoid will fill in the rest of the space from the oblique line of the thyroid cartilage all the way up to the hyoid bone. So this will be the thyrohyoid, because here is your hyoid bone. So these infrahyoid muscles are super intuitive once you learn their names because they explicitly describe their attachment points, which will help you with identification. Let's finish this discussion with one of the suprahyoid muscles, the digastric muscle. We have this one here because it is often visible in an anterior neck dissection. As you can see, the anterior bellies of the digastric right here. You can see it right here above the hyoid bone. So here are some of those strap muscles, or the infrahyoid muscles here, specifically the deep dissection. And then right above the hyoid, you're getting into the suprahyoid muscles, and that anterior belly of digastric is really visible. This muscle, like the omohyoid, has two bellies, but instead they're called anterior and posterior. So here is the anterior belly of digastric. This is its intermediate tendon. And this will be the posterior belly of the digastric. We will return to this muscle in session 5 when we're discussing the submandibular triangle, which is right around this region here. Here's your submandibular gland right there. And we'll also return to it in the oral cavity session. All right, thank you for your attention here. And as always, please feel free to reach out to me with any questions. Have a great day.